Hi, myself Professor Jitendra Engle, Senior Lecturer from Praveen Patil College of Diploma Engineering Technology, Naugar Bhayandar East. Our today's topic is voice, that is active voice and passive voice. Voice is an important part in English grammar. We always use voice in our day-to-day language. Course outcomes. Format grammatically correct sentences. Student able to change the active voice and passive voice from specified situation or passage. Student can apply relevant voice in formal communication for the given passage. These are the learning outcomes student will achieve after completion of this topic. So students, active voice and passive voice. So what is active voice and what is passive voice? We will discuss. Voice is the form of verb which indicate whether subject does something or something has done to it. Means active voice means the subject, active and passive voice. There are two types of voice. In active voice, subject do the action, or in passive voice, the action has been done by subject. Means third person doing the action through the subject in passive voice. So let's see how and where to use the active voice and where to use the passive voice. Active voice. In active voice, when subject is the agent or doer of the action, the verb is in active voice. Means subject do the action, or the action which is done by the subject in active voice. Such types of verb is used in the sentence. It is called as an active verb, or it is an active voice. For example, the boy makes a kite. In this example, the verb makes show that the subject, the boy, does something. Here, doer of the action is important. The subject act, so it is called as an active voice. Means in this example, subject makes indicate the boy doing something. What he did? He did, or he makes a kite. Means the action of making the kite is done by the student or the subject. That's why makes is a active voice or active verb. Then passive voice. When subject is the target or receiver of the action, the verb is said to the passive voice. Means action is done by the subject. For example, a kite is made by the boy. In this example, the verb phrase is made shows that something is done to the subject, a kite. Here the person or the thing acted upon is to be made a prominent thing. The subject is not active, but the receiver, some action is to be called as a passive voice. Means the action which is done by the subject. In this example, subject is not active, but some third person which is done the action through subject. Such types of verb is called as a passive verb, means the passive voice. So this is the basic difference between active and passive voice. Then let's see how to transfer the voice, active to passive and passive to voice. Okay, so one by one let's we see. First of all, we see what are the changes in assertive types of sentence. So students, we know that there are four types of sentence: assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and exclamatory types of sentence. These are the four types of sentence. So one by one we will see how we can change the sentence or the voice from active to passive or passive to active. So also there are some rules how to change active to passive and passive to voice. So what are the rules, what are the important thing which we have to do while transferring the sentence? So let's see the assertive sentence. Number one, that is statement. In this sentence, subject, verb and object, such are the subject or grammatical pattern is used in the sentence. So we see, number one, in these types of sentence structure is subject, verb and object. Means while transferring sentence active to passive or passive to active, subject and object changes their place. Mean they are interchange themselves. Subject take place as object. Object take place as a subject. Number two, the past participle form of the verb is always used in the sentence while transferring active to passive. Means passive verb is always come with the helping verb and third form of the verb. Means past participle of the verb form is always used in passive voice. The word by is also used in the sentence or in the passive structure before the subject. Means when we transfer subject at the place of object, subject transfer in its second form. For example, I transfer into me, we transfer into us. Before the subject second form, we use by. Mean these are the some changes while we transferring sentence. Number one, subject take place, subject and object place interchanges. Then in passive voice, helping verb plus V3, that is means past participle of the verb is always used and by is used. Okay, so these are the changes we will do while transferring the sentence from active to passive. Then here are some changes while transferring sentence from active to passive or passive to active. Okay, what are the changes in pronouns? So what are the changes in pronouns, we will see. Okay, I, if subject is I, transfer into me. Subject is we, transfer into us. Subject is you, transfer into you. Means there is no change in subject. If subject is he, transfer into him. If subject is she, transfer into her. Subject is it, transfer into it. If subject is they, transfer into them. Means I, me, we, us, we, you, you, he, him, she, her, it, they, them. These are the changes in pronoun, that is personal pronoun, while transferring sentence active to passive or passive to active. Let's see, okay, what are the changes in different types of sentence? There are, we know that there are the 12 types of tenses. In it, the 8 tense we will transfer from active to passive. Present continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense, future continuous tense and future perfect continuous tense. We can't change active to passive because we do not have the supportive or active verb. While transforming the sentence from active to passive, passive to active, these 4 tenses can't change in itself. So number one, simple present tense. So what are the changes in simple present tense while transferring sentence active to passive? In simple present tense, sentence structure is subject plus V1 plus object, means subject plus verb plus object. In this tense, subject in plus verb into first form is used plus object is used. For example, he writes a letter. So this is the active voice because verb into first form is used in the sentence. So how to transfer this sentence in passive voice? What are the passive structure of this sentence? While transforming this tense in active to passive, we know that subject and object interchange their places. Means subject take place as object, object take place as a subject. Then we also know that helping verb plus verb into third form is used and by plus subject into second form. So what are the structure? Object plus helping verb, that is amizar, plus verb into third form plus by plus subject into second form. Then sentence is I write a letter. So transfer in passive voice, a letter is written by me. So these are the changes we are doing while transferring sentence active to passive and passive to active. Number second, present continuous tense. Subject plus amizar plus verb plus object. In this sentence, she is completing project. Is completing project. Okay, is a helping verb, complete is a main verb, plus ing form is used, is indicate verb in continuous form, means it's a continuous tense. Then which continuous tense? So as per helping verb is used, so it is a present continuous tense. So while transferring passive voice, object plus amizar plus being plus V3 plus by plus subject into second form is used. Though tense is continuous tense, that's why we use additional or extra helping verb from be family, that is being, because we want to keep the continuous flow in the sentence. And also complete transparent to V3, that is completed. So how to change? So the project is being completed by her. Object, the project, is helping verb, being for continuous tense, and completed for V3 by her, etc. Present perfect tense. Subject plus have has plus V3 plus object. Okay. Then they have done the work. If the sentence is given with transferring passive voice, object plus have has plus been plus V3 plus by plus subject into second form. Means the work has been done by them. Okay. So these are the changes from active to passive in a simple present tense, present continuous tense, and present perfect tense. Then last, present perfect continuous tense, we do not change in passive voice because we do not have an additional or extra helping verb or supporting verb to transfer the sentence. Then simple past, subject plus verb into second form plus object is used, means he wrote a letter. Then this is active voice, verb into second form is used. Then how to transfer in passive voice? Object plus was verb plus V3 plus by plus subject into second form. A letter was written by him. Okay. So the active transparent to passive voice. Though subject is wrote, so though subject is he, we transfer it to him. Though subject is the verb is V2, so we use was and were for past action. And write, that is wrote, transfer it to V3, that is written. Okay. A letter was written by him. Past continuous tense, subject plus was verb plus verb plus ing plus object. She was completing the project. She was watching a TV. She was completing a book, etc. So was completing means was verb indicating the past action, and completing, that is continuous action indicating continuous action, means continuous tense is there. Means past continuous tense is there. Then how to transfer in passive voice? Object plus was verb plus being plus V3 plus by plus subject into second form is used. The project was being completed by her. Okay. In this example, the project is object, was indicating the past action, being indicates the continuous action, and though it's a passive voice, we use completed, means complete word into third form of completed, is completed by her. Past perfect tense, subject plus had plus V3 plus object. They had done the work. In this example, they, subject, had past helping verb for past tense, okay, which is always used in past perfect tense, and done is a V3 verb in third form. So this is the very simple and easy tense for transforming passive voice. Only just we add been, okay, B double EN. So let's see how to transfer the sentence in active to passive. Object plus had plus been plus verb in third form plus by plus subject into second form. The work had been done by them. In this example, the work is a object, had, it's a past tense, or about the past helping verb, been, we use the extra or additional helping verb for transferring active to passive in perfect tense, and done is verb in third form, means the work had been done by them. So these are the changes in past tense, simple past, past continuous, and past perfect tense. Past perfect continuous tense we can't change in active to passive voice because we do not have any supporting or extra helping verb. Future tense, that is simple future tense. Subject plus shall plus will plus V1 plus object. In this tense, will shall is used as a helping verb and verb into first form is used. For example, he will finish the work. Then this is the active voice and how to transfer the sentence in passive voice. Object plus shall plus will plus be plus V3 plus by plus subject into second form is used for transforming sentence. The work will be finished by them. In this example, subject take place as object, object take place as object, will shall to indicate the future tense, so we keep as it is. So will is used instead of shall.
Okay,
if subject is I and we, then we use shall, otherwise we will we. If you have a doubt, so we can use always we as a helping verb. Do not confuse regarding will and shall. If you have a doubt, so always we use will at the place of shall. Then plus be plus v3 plus by plus him means the work will be finished by him. So this is a simple future tense. Then future continuous tense we can't transfer into passive voice because we do not have a supporting or extra helping verb, because the be is there, so we already use be in passive voice of simple future tense. The future perfect tense, subject plus will plus shall plus have plus v3 plus object means he will have finished the work. In this example, will have finished the verb. The simple future perfect tense is used. It has a active verb, it has a active voice, so we are transferring it in a passive form or passive voice. Object plus will have plus been plus v3 plus by plus subject into second form. So the work will have been finished by them. In this example, we transfer the subject at the place of object, then also change the verb. Will we use that as it is, have we do not change, it indicate the perfect action, and been additional or extra helping verb or supportive verb we are used in this tense, and finish as a verb into third form is used. So the work will have been finished by them. So such are the changes we have seen in active to passive and passive to active in a statement or assertive types of sentence as per the 12 different types of tenses. So students, I hope you all of us know that how to transfer the sentence from active to passive or passive to active. But before transforming sentence, you should have to keep some things in your mind. First of all, subject take place as object and object take place as a subject. Second thing, while transforming subject as a place of object, we always use subject into second form. Next, while transforming verb in passive voice, we always use verb into third form, that is past participle of the verb we are always using there. Then as per the different types of tense, out of 12 tense we just transfer 8 tense from active to passive. So you just focus on this thing. First of all, identifying the tense. As per the specific tense, we are using the exact or specific or exact supporting helping verb. For example, present tense is there, so we use am, is, are, have, has, etc. If past tense is there, we use was, were, had, etc. If future tense is there, we use will, shall, etc. So as per the tense, we are using the supporting helping verb. Then while transferring in passive voice, verb into third form is always used in any tense. If continuous tense is there, we use being. If perfect tense is there, we use been. So if you know that such are the changes while transferring sentence from active to passive voice, so you do not have any problem to transforming any kinds of tense from active to passive or passive to active. While transforming this sentence from active to passive, you know very well, okay, what are the different types of tenses, their helping verb, and also the past participle of that particular verb. If you know all these things, if you identify the exact tense, so you do not have any problem, you do not have any doubts, you do not have any complexity to transforming the sentence. So students, I hope you learned this topic very well. So wish you best of luck to you. Thank you.